In this video, I'm going to talk about taxonomy, branches of taxonomy, taxonomic hierarchy, taxon in detail, examples. So stay tuned. Starting with taxonomy, one of the oldest and the most fundamental branch of biology dealing with identification, nomenclature and classification of living organisms is called taxonomy. It is derived from two Greek words, taxis meaning arrangement and nomos meaning law. It is also called as systematics. The word systematics is derived from Greek word systema, which means systems or orders or sequences. Scientists who study and contribute to the classification of organisms are known as systematists or taxonomists. The term taxonomy was coined by A.P. de Candolle in 1813. Let us see the branches of taxonomy. Taxonomy is divided into two major branches. Classical taxonomy. The classical taxonomy is based on information available and attempting to classify the organism according to their origin, evolution and variation. Second is modern taxonomy or new systematics. The term new systematics was proposed by Sir Julian Huxley in 1940. In new systematics, species are considered interrelated, mutable, and work of gradual modification. This is in conformity with facts of evolution. New systematics or modern taxonomy is further divided into morphotaxonomy. It is based on morphological characters of an organism. Cytotaxonomy. It is based on cytological information of cell, numbers of chromosome, structure and behavior of chromosomes during meiosis. Karyotaxonomy. It is a branch of taxonomy based on banding patterns of chromosomes. Experimental taxonomy. It is based on experiments determining genetic interrelationships. Chemotaxonomy or biochemical taxonomy. It is based on protein and serum analysis on particular chemicals like secondary metabolites. Numerical or phonetic or Adansonian taxonomy. It involves qualitative analysis of similarities and differences in order to make objective assessment. Characters of organisms are given equal weight and the relationship organism is numerically determined. Now we'll talk about taxonomic hierarchy. Starting with the definition, taxonomic hierarchy is the sequence or arrangement of taxonomic categories or taxons in a descending order during the classification of organisms. Hierarchy was first given by Linnaeus, who used only five categories, which are class, order, genus, species, and variety. Variety was discarded and more three categories were added, creating seven obligate categories. Some categories have been added to this list. They are called as intermediate categories. Example, subkingdom, superphylum or subdivision, subphylum or subdivision, superclass, subclass, superorder, suborder, superfamily, subfamily, tribe, species, etc. Now let us see what taxon is. Taxon, the term taxon is used to represent any unit of classification. The term taxon was used in 1926 by Adolf Meyer Abich for animal groups. For plants, it was proposed by Hermann Johannes Lamb in 1948 and was adopted at the 7th International Botanical Congress held in 1950. domain. The term domain was proposed by Carl Woese, Otto Kandler, and Mark Willis in 1990, is a three-domain system but not considered in any nomenclature. According to this system, the tree of life consists of three domains: archaea, bacteria, and eukarya. Kingdom. It is the highest category in biological classification. Division or phylum. Georges Leopold Cuvier, French naturalist, added phylum in the taxonomy. It is a major group in the taxonomic hierarchy used in the classification. The subcategory of division is subdivision. Generally, in botany and microbiology, the word division is used instead of phylum, although the International Code of Nomenclature for algae, fungi, and plants accept the term as equivalent. Class. Division is divided into one or more classes. The subcategory of class is subclasses or series. Class consists of organisms least similar to each other. Order. Order was introduced by Linnaeus in 1735. The class consists of one or more orders. The subcategory of order is suborder. Family. An order is divided into one or more families. The subcategories of family is subfamily, tribe, and subtribe. Genus. The plural of genus is genera. It comprises of groups of related species which has more characteristics in common than the species of other genera. The subcategories of genus are subgenus, section, and subsection. Species. It was introduced by John Ray in taxonomy in 1693. It is the smallest rank and basic unit of taxonomic classification. A genus may include one or more species. The subcategory of species are subspecies, varieties, subvarieties, forms, and subforms. The correct sequence for taxonomy is domain, kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. So now let us see each term with examples. Let us consider the taxonomic hierarchy for Royal Bengal tiger. First comes the domain. There are three domains: eukarya, bacteria, and archaea. Domain eukarya consists of kingdoms like Animalia, Plantae, Fungi, Protista. In kingdom Animalia, there are many phyla like Porifera, Nidera, Echinodermata, Tenophora, Annelida, Arthropoda, Chordata, etc. In phylum Chordata, there are classes like Agnatha, Reptilia, Amphibia, Aves, Mammalia, and many more. Considering class Mammalia, it is divided into orders like Prudentia, Chiroptera, Soricomorpha, Primates, Carnivora, etc. Taking order Carnivora under consideration, it consists of families like Canidae, dogs; Ursidae, bears; Hyaenidae, hyenas; Felidae, cats, etc. Under family Felidae, there are 14 genera, of which some are Felix, Lynx, Leopardus, Echinonyx, Neophelix, and Panthera. In genus Panthera, there are 5 species. They are Tigris, Onca, Onchia, Ardus, and Leo. For tigers, we will consider Panthera tigris. In this species, there are subspecies, of which many are extinct. Panthera tigris altaica is Siberian tiger. Panthera tigris amoyensis is South China tiger. And Panthera tigris tigris is our Royal Bengal tiger. That's all for today. For the next video on introduction of parasitism, please like and subscribe the channel.